Hey, this is Three String Guitar Lesson Part 3. All getting rid of and keeping. It's all we're interested in. I'm not suggesting that you won't play these chords at some point. They're pains in the asses right now, and why jump in when you can increase the dexterity of these, and your muscle memory of these, and also benefit from the carrot, which is being able to play a song. So all you need to know is in lesson one, and so here's lesson three. We'll introduce two new shapes, and so have your book showing you this, and called it a D7. Probably put an X in your book there on the little chord graph, and said strum that thing across like that, and you've got a D7 chord. Well, since we're only using the top three, what I can't tell you about this is that this is a movable chord. So you've got a D and then a G, G sharp, A and C, and so on and so forth. But right now we're interested right here. Let me turn that up a little. And listen to the sound. There's a D7, even though it doesn't contain, there's an E7. Even though it doesn't contain an E, it doesn't have to. More on that some future date. Here is an E. It does contain the actual E note. Listen to the difference. Now, listen to the seventh. Hear the difference? If you can't, you will. If you can, good for you. Now, so I've got one seventh shape. I need another one. Since this is an E7, I'll come down here and get another E7 known from experience. I'm going to put my weakest finger down first, and then that's here, and then here, and there. And that is an E7 too. So here is the here's an E7 chord, for example. Well, so, and I get the same effect. And you'll see me making it like this. I do not make this chord like this, but oh, do. It won't hurt you at all. You know, you don't have to play it this way. You know, some people play it this way. It's in the garden, your garden. So, now the travesty of me singing. Do forgive me, but it's a necessity. Oh, and I'm going to butcher, low light, stab, pickle stab, the great Hoagie Carmichael's beautiful standard, Georgia. And I'm going to use those two new shapes with all the chords that you may or may not have already learned. So we get the Georgia. Georgia. Whole day through, it comes sweet and clear like moonlight through the pine. Huh? Let me play that in a rhythmic. Let me put some rhythm to that. That's how I'm making this chord too in this situation, but I'm using the sevenths. A real quick go over of those shapes. The major chord and the root inversion to that newly learned seventh chord. Let's call the chords out too, why not? This is a C, and this is a E7. And then we're going to an A minor right here. Ho! And now, we need a, and that's an A minor in the first inversion shape. And now here's a second inversion, F minor through, and then back to the C, sweet, and the first inversion major chord A, and then a root inversion minor chord right here, moonlight, and then here is, and I suggest, when you get here and you want to go to make the G7, the simplest move is to just put that pinky through the pine. So Georgia, Georgia, the whole night through, come sweet and clear, like moonlight through the pine. Or now, Georgia, Georgia, the whole day through, it comes sweet and clear like moonlight through the pine, etc. So we're getting the C right here from the first inversion, and then we're putting this 7th right here, Georgia, and then A minor here from the 2nd inversion minor shape, and then we're getting the F minor here from the root inversion minor shape, and then from C 1st inversion to A 1st inversion to root inversion minor, D minor, and then the G7, and then my bite. Yeah, so have fun. Thanks for watching. Any questions, drop me a line. Have a good one.